Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergy. We've been talking a fair bit about war and North Korea, but sometimes you need to go right back to the root of the internet. Cats. They're cute, they're cuddly, and they have an amazing habit of landing on their feet. But just how do they do it? Let's explore. Now get ready, it's time to ask the question, why do cats always land on their feet? One mechanism holds the key to this phenomenon. The cat riding reflex. The cat riding reflex begins to appear at 3 to 4 weeks of age, coming into full form by 6 or 7 weeks. Taking advantage of the unusually flexible backbone and the lack of functional clavicle, cats are able to flip themselves over in midair. This can be done when falling as low as a foot from the ground. But how exactly is this accomplished? Well, first the cat determines which way is up, using the vestibular apparatus in the inner ear. It then uses a series of movements to twist downwards, so that its feet are down. It bends in the middle, thus causing the front and rear halves of the body to rotate about different axes. The front legs are then tucked to reduce the moment of inertia of the front half, while the rear legs are extended to increase the moment of inertia in the back half. This causes the front to rotate fully so the legs are facing down, while the back legs and tail rotate slightly in the opposite direction. From here, all that's left to do is extend the front legs and tuck the rear legs so that the back half of the cat rotates down and Bob's your uncle. They make it look so easy. So that's the riding reflex down, which allows them to land on their feet when falling. But wouldn't they still break their legs if they fell on their feet from high up? A human falling 10 meters onto his or her feet would likely come out with a broken leg or worse, while cats have been recorded falling 26 stories and walking away without injury. What is going on with these cats that keeps them from meeting the same fate as Mustafa in Austin Powers?
I think my legs might be broken, but I'll try to stand up.
Well, cats have a few advantages over humans in this respect. Their smaller size, lighter bones, and fur help to decrease their terminal velocity. For those out of the loop, terminal velocity refers to the speed at which something will stop accelerating due to the effects of gravity. In the case of a cat, this value is roughly 60 miles per hour, compared to the 120 mile an hour terminal velocity for the average human. This means the cat won't fall faster than that, regardless of how high up it starts. Interestingly, while injury rate from a fall tends to go up the farther a cat falls, some studies have found that this ceases to be the case above 7 stories. There are 2 explanations for this. The first and simplest is that cats that fall from higher distances are more likely to die and therefore less likely to be taken to the hospital to have the injuries reported. There is, however, a rather interesting alternative hypothesis for how cats manage to survive falls at terminal velocity. It's believed by some that this decrease in injury when reaching terminal velocity is caused by the tenseness of the animal. While accelerating, the cat is often quite tense with an arched back, which is beneficial for short falls but disastrous when falling at higher speeds. However, as it approaches terminal velocity, it's believed that a cat relaxes its body, going spread eagle, thus increasing the surface area to distribute the impact evenly. This idea is supported by the difference in injuries found in cats falling from higher and shorter heights, with those falling at or near terminal velocity sporting injuries in different areas from their short falling brethren. This means that a cat could potentially be dropped from any distance and survive, which makes you wonder why you don't see more cats skydiving. And now we return to our question, why do cats always land on their feet? Well, thanks to the cat riding reflex, they're able to manipulate their legs and spine to rotate their body in a very short time. But it doesn't stop there. Their smaller size and lighter bones, combined with spreading eagle to increase surface area, allows them to achieve a terminal velocity roughly half that of humans. This means that a house cat could potentially survive a fall from any height, but don't go throwing cats out of planes. That's just cruel. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, let me know the furthest you've ever fallen, and if you landed on your feet. If you want more science videos, check out our Biggest Science Questions playlist on the channel. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergy with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.